Well, in the previous section, we had discussed about the production of alternators. Now, in this section, we are discussing about the protection of transformers as well as bus bars. After that, objective type questions are there, and you may ask your questions or your doubts in the after the section. Now, coming to the protection of transformers, as compared to the alternators, the transformers may suffer from the following faults. Those are, one is open circuits, and you see in this caption, first one is open circuit, that is common faults in a transformers. First one is open circuits, second one is overheating and winding short circuits, such as earth fault, face to face fault and inter turn faults. So, these are the some common faults occurred in the transformers. Now, we will discuss one by one. First one is open circuit fault. In the open circuit faults, normally power transformers are three phase transformers. So, in any one of the single phase, in any one of the phase is opened, the load is carried by the other two phases. Due to this, undesirable heating occurred. Due to this, what happens in the one phase is opened, the load is carried by the other two phases. Due to this, undesirable heating occurs. So, in this way, it is protected from this overheating, this heating. So, normally here the automatic relay protection is not provided, because here the metering units are there, there is measuring units, measuring meters are there, they will see the each phase voltage currents. So, in this way the meters are indicating the measuring voltages or currents. So, one of the phase is not working, so that phase meter is not showing voltage or current. Due to this, the station operator comes and disconnect the transformer manually on occurrence of these faults. Next one is overheating. In the transformers, overheating is normally occurred due to sustained overloads or short circuits, sometimes failure of the cooling system. So, in this way also, the automatic relay protection is not provided here also, because there is a thermal as series are provided in the transformers. So, they are taking care of these faults and giving a sound, that is alarm circuit is connected to the thermal as series. So, any overheating occurs, these thermal as series gives a sound, that is alarm, and station operator comes and disconnected the faulty transformer from the system. Next one is winding short circuits. So, these winding short circuits normally occur due to the deterioration of the insulation due to overheating or short circuit. Due to this, what happens? These are called internal faults. These internal faults are very dangerous, and the transformer is not disconnected, the transformer may burst, because the heat, that means the arc developed in the inside the transformer, and the oil is inside the transformer. So, the oil catches fire due to this arcs, and so the transformer bursts. So, here we need a automatic protective relay system. for internal faults. So these are the normal common faults occurred in the transformers. So next one is how these are protected. So there are some protective systems are there. The protective systems of the transformers are like this. You see in this protective systems for transformers. First one is Buchholz relay. So this is relay. The protection against all kinds of incipient faults. Incipient means slow developing internal faults, such as insulation failure of windings, core heating, fall of oil level due to leaky joints, etc. So this is the one type of protective system. Next, other protective system is earth fault relays. So protection against earth faults only. Overcurrent relays, protection against phase to phase faults and overloading. Fourth one is differential relays, protection against both earth faults and phase to phase faults. So these are the normal protective schemes, those are applied to the transformers. So in this way, first one is Buchholz relay. So Buchholz relay is a gas operated relay. It is installed between the pipe connecting the main transformer to the conservator. So this Buchholz relays are used on transformers of rating or size above 750 kVA, and the Buchholz relay is connected like this as shown in figure. So first one is the main transformer tank, and it is number 2 is the connecting pipe. In between the connecting pipe, third one is Buchholz relay. The relay is installed here, and fourth one is the conservator. So the Buchholz relay is connected like this. So coming to its construction, the Buchholz relay is a domed shaped vessel, and it is like this as shown in the figure. You see in the figure. So this is the Buchholz relay. This is a domed vessel, and it having one is the test cock, that is testing purpose. This cock is open, and second one is the air vent cock, that means any trapped air is leaked through this cock. And third one is, here is a arrow. This arrow indicate the direction of flow of the current, direction of flow of the oil from main tank of the transformer to the conservator. And fourth one is glass window. The glass window is here to see the color of the gas inside the Buchholz relay. So the color of gas also gives us the type of fault occurred in the transformer. And fifth one is indicator, red indicator, and here it is marked as S. It is not visible here. It is indicated as S. S means service, that means the relay is under service. And sixth one is scale, the scale of the volume of the gas. So in cubic centimeters, the scale is in cubic centimeter. So how much gas is produced is in the visible in the scale. And seventh one is also another red indicator, it is marked as T by L. Here it also not visible. T stands for test, T stands for testing, L stands for location. And eighth one is, here the pipe is connecting to the conservator. Here is opening is there. It is connected to the conservator, that is outlet to the conservator. And ninth one is alarm circuit. There is two terminals are there, and these two terminals are connected to the alarm circuit. And tenth one is, it is a hole is there. In this hole a conduit it is placed. Through this conduit the terminals are connected. That means through the conduit cables are run. These cables are connected to inside the circuit. And 11th one is trip circuit terminals. There are also two terminals are there. These two terminals are connected to the trip circuit. 12th one is inlet. That is from transformer tank to the buck holes relay. So 12th one is inlet and 8th one is the outlet to conservator. So normally the construction of the buck holes relay is like this. That means it has already you are seen there are two circuits. One is alarm circuit, the other one is trip circuit. Alarm circuit is meant for the incipient faults, that is slow developing faults, whereas trip circuits are several severe internal faults. That is, it is connected, it is operated only severe internal faults occurs in the transformers. Now we will see the operation of the buck holes relay. The operation of the buck holes relay is like this. So this is the inside picture of the buck holes relay. One is the air release cock, that is vent cock. Second one is the float. Third one is the connected to the trip circuit. Ninth one is the mercury switch. Here you see the mercury. The color of the mercury is in blue, light blue mercury. And fourth one is, this is the outlet to the conservator. Fifth one is test cock. Sixth one is flap. This flap is hinged here. And seventh one is the inlet from the transformer main tank. And eighth one is the hinged support. This is the hinged support to the two switches, mercury switches. And again nine, it is also a mercury switch. The mercury is inside this and there are two terminals. And this is connected to the alarm circuit. So the inside picture is like this in the buck holes relay. So here for operation purpose, we will divide here two types of faults. First one is incipient faults, that is slow developing faults. Second one is severe internal faults. So for incipient faults, alarm circuit is closed. For severe internal faults, trip circuit is closed. So how it is closed is like this. So in the event of incipient faults, that is slow developing faults, there is a heat developed in the transformer. Due to this heat, some of the transformer oil gets decomposed. So the decomposed products of transformer oil consists of more than 70% of hydrogen. So hydrogen is lighter. Hydrogen is a lighter, so it is traveled to the conservator through the connecting pipe to the buck holes relay. So in this process, the hydrogen gas is entrapped in the upper chamber of the buck holes relay. So this hydrogen gas is accumulated in the upper chamber. So sufficient, that is predetermined amount of hydrogen gas is accumulated in the upper chamber. Then what happens? Here it is a float, hinged float. So it is a tilted. It tilt means the mercury switch is tilted so that the mercury is contact to the other terminal. So in contact the other terminal, there is a closed circuit. The circuit is closed. Here the mercury is closes this contact. So the circuit is closed like this. Here it is a alarm circuit. Then it gives a signals to alarm circuit and the sound is observed. Then the operator comes and disconnect the transformer from the system. So this is the incipient faults occurs, then the transformer is disconnected. Now severe internal faults. In the severe event of internal faults, what happens? Enormous heat is developed. Due to this enormous heat, enormous gas also developed. In this way, the enormous gas developed, the oil in the transformer is rushes to the conservator through this. So in doing so, the trip contacts are placed in the direct path of the oil which goes to the conservator from the transformer tank. So in doing so, the oil is rushes and applies on this flap. So this is the flap, this is injured here. So on this way, in this way, the mercury switch, here also mercury switch, the mercury switch, again it is tilted. In tilting, what happens? The mercury is contact to the other terminal. So then there is a circuit closed, and the circuit is connected to the trip coil. Then trip coil operates, then trip coil operates, circuit breaker comes into picture, and this circuit breaker isolate the transformer from the system. Likewise, the incipient faults as well as severe internal faults are protected in the transformer in this way. So this is the Buchholz relay production, and it has also some advantages and disadvantages. Those are the advantages of the Buchholz relays are like this. Advantages of Buchholz relay: it is the simplest form of transformer protection. It detects the incipient faults at a stage much earlier than other forms of protection, which is possible. So these are the two advantages, and there is also disadvantages of this relay. Those are: it can only be used with oil immersed transformers equipped with conservator. So Buchholz relay is only used for oil immersed transformers, and also there is a conservator must installed, then only the Buchholz relay is used. Then second disadvantage is the relay can detect only faults below oil level in the transformer. Therefore, separate protection is needed for connecting cables. So these relays are used only for internal faults. For external faults, separate relays, protective relays are employed. So this is the protection of Buchholz relay applied to the transformers. So next one is earth fault protection. Normally, earth faults involves the winding, that is partial breakdown of the winding insulation to the earth. In doing so, the earth current flows, and it flows, it will give us considerable damage, and it will be allowed for some long time. It will develop into a short circuit before it is removed from the supply. So in this way, earth fault relays are profitable to employ for these faults to ensure the disconnection of the earth faults or leakage faults in the early stage. So earth fault relays are normally overcurrent relays of lower current setting, and such type of overcurrent relay which is used for the earth fault relays is as shown in the figure. You will see in the figure. So here it is the three phase windings. One is the secondary winding, two is the primary winding, three is the current transformer, fourth one is the secondary winding of the current transformer, and it is secondary winding is connected to the relay and relay coil, that is trip coil circuit relay, and relay is which is connected to the trip circuit. So here the three windings are taken through the single current transformer, and this current transformer having a only single secondary winding, and it is connected to the trip coil circuit. So here first operating, considering the operation. So normal operating conditions, what happens? Under normal operating conditions, the currents in the three windings, that is R winding, Y winding, B winding, are vector sum of these currents are equal to 0. Therefore, the current inside the current transformer is 0. Therefore, there is no current or no EMF induced in the secondary winding of the transformer. So therefore, there is no current flows to the relay. Therefore, the relay cannot operate under normal operating conditions. Suppose any earth fault occurs on this any one of the phases. Due to this, what happens? The vector sum of the currents not equal to 0. So there is a current. That current flows through the current transformer. Due to the flow of current, the cores, the flux is sets up in the current transformer core. The flux is sets up in the current transformer core. Due to this flux, the EMF is induced in this winding, and that winding, that induced EMF is sufficient to energize this coil, and it will contacts are closed and it goes to trip circuit. Then the trip circuit operates and disconnect the transformer from both sides, that is secondary side as well as primary side. The transformer is disconnected from the earth faults. So this is the earth fault protection of the transformer. Now another protection is overload protection. Here we will go to the overload protection. We will combine the earth fault protection as well as overload protection, that is combined earth fault or leakage and overload protection. So why we are combining these two, that is earth fault as well as overload protection? Because the complete protection of transformer, the complete protection of transformer does not sufficient protection is provided using any single protection system. That's why we are combining the protective system, that is combination of protective systems are normally applied to the transformers. So before applying this combination, what particular combination is applied? So this is depends upon the following factors, such as first one is size of the transformer, that is rating of the transformer. Second one is type of cooling applied on the transformer. Third one is location of the transformer in the network. Fourth one is nature of the load supplied by the transformer or nature of the service. Fifth one is importance of the service or load. So these are the factors influence the particular combination of the protective systems applied to the transformers. That's why here we are applying a combined earth fault or leakage and overload protection. Here such type of protection is applied in the transformer, that is as seen in the figure. This is the combined earth fault as well as overload protection. Here also one is the secondary winding, two is the primary winding, that is three phase primary winding, and these are the three CTs. The three CTs are connected in the three lines, and first CT, that is current transformer, is connected to the overload coil, and second CT is connected to the earth relay, and third current transformer is connected again overload relays. So here we are using two overload relays. So these two overload relays are sufficient to protect the transformer from phase to phase faults on all the three phases. And again only one earth relay is used, and this earth relay is sufficient to protect all the three phases which are encountered earth fault. So under normal working conditions, you will see the working of this relay. Under normal working conditions, the current through this windings are sufficient, that is these are the overload relays, we set some value, so that value it will bypasses. Suppose we will set sufficient, that is short circuit current, we set a short circuit, particular short circuit current. When a short circuit current flows through this overload relays, then these relays operates and it will gives to circuit, trip circuit. Third one is the trip circuit, where trip circuit operates and it will operate the circuit breaker. The circuit breaker disconnects this primary side as well as secondary side also. Suppose any earth fault also occurs, the earth fault relay also sets some value compared to lower value, compared to overload relays, this value is low. So this also operates under fault, that is earth fault comes on any one phase, this relay operates, and this due to this relay the contacts are closed and this is connected to the trip circuit. Again trip circuit disconnects the transformer from both primary side as well as secondary side. Like this, combined at fault as well as overload protection or phase to phase protection are applied to the transformer. Next, coming to the last one, that is differential protection or major price circulating protection system. So before applying this protective system to the transformers, there is a complicating features in the transformers. So those are the complicating features. We will first remedy or compensation of these particular compensation takes place, otherwise we will not apply this merge price as well as our circulating current system, because circulating current system is easy applied to the alternators, but here it is not so easy, it is applied to the transformers, because there is a complicating features are there in the transformers. Those are four types of complicating features are there. First one is turns ratio, second one is phase difference, third one is tap changers, and last one is energizing the transformer from the rest. So we will see the these complicating features and how they were remedy or compensation to be applied. So first one is turns ratio. You see in the figure, the complicating feature is in power transformer, the primary and the secondary currents are different. Why different? So primary is connected star position, star fashion, secondary is connected delta fashion, then there is a difference between the two currents. Therefore, turns ratio also differs. So the use of identical CTs will give differential current and operate the relay even under no load conditions. So this is the complicating feature, one of the complicating feature. How this is compensated? The compensation is like this, a remedial measure. Different turns ratio of CTs to be selected such that T, the turns ratio of power transformer, then the turns ratio of CTs on the LV side is made T times that of the CTs on the HV side, so that the secondaries of the CTs will carry identical currents under normal load conditions. Consequently, no differential current will flow through the relay and it remains inoperative. So we will adjust the, here the remedy is we will adjust the turns ratio of the current transformers so that the CTs will carry identical currents. So therefore there is no differential current flows through the operating coil of the relay. So therefore under normal working conditions the relay cannot operate. So for this only compensation for turns ratio only. Another complicating feature is like this. Second one, this is usually there is a phase difference between the primary and the secondary currents of a three phase power transformer. Even if CTs of proper turns ratio are used, as said earlier, a differential current may flow through the relay under normal load conditions and cause relay operation. So here is the effect is the phase difference. How it is compensated? The compensation is like this. The connections of CTs should be connected so that the phase difference may be compensated. Those is remedial measure. This remedy is corrected by appropriate connections of CTs. The table below shows such types of connections. So the table is like this. Connections of CTs to compensate for the phase difference in the primary and secondary currents of power transformer. So this is serial number, four types of connections are there. The power transformer connections are here. These are the power transformer connections. These are the current transformer connections. First one is, so there is a windings, primary winding on power transformer, secondary winding of the power transformer. Similarly, current transformer, primary winding, secondary winding. So suppose primary winding of the power transformer is connected in star with neutral earthed. Star having a neutral point, so that neutral point is earthed. That is the primary connection, primary winding connection. Secondary winding connection is in delta fashion. So the remedial for phase difference is the connections of the CT primary is delta. See here, it is star, it is connected in delta. Similarly, secondary of the power transformer connected in delta, then CT connection is in star fashion. Similarly, delta connection of the primary of the power transformer, secondary connection also delta, then primary of the CT star. Similarly, CT secondary connected in star, that is right opposite, delta connection, so it is the star connection. It is delta connection, it is star connection. Similarly, third one, star of the primary of the power transformer, secondary is star with neutral earthed. CT connections, CT primary is connected in delta and also secondary also connected in delta. That is here star, it is delta, here it is star, here it is delta. And last one is primary is of the power transformer connected in delta, secondary is connected in star with neutral earthed. So CT connection, current transformer connections are star, delta. So in this way, the phase difference of the power transformer can be compensated. So this is the second remedial feature. Third remedial feature is like this, that is tap changers. Most transformers have tap changers, which makes the problem more hard, more difficult. Tap changing will cause differential current to flow through the relay even under normal load operating conditions. So this is the third complicating feature. How it is compensated? The compensation is like this. This difficulty is overcome by adjusting the turns ratio of CTs on the side of the power transformer provided with tappings. Here, what is a tap changing? The tap changing means the producing more voltage by adding more turns. We call it as a tap changing. Due to this, turns ratio changes. For this change of the turns ratio, transformer turns ratio must and should be changed. That's why the CTs also, accordingly, the turns ratio of CTs should be altered, such that this remedy is, this compensation is occurred. And last one is magnetizing current. Another complication in transformer protection is the magnetizing inrush current. Under normal load conditions, the magnetizing current is very small. However, when a transformer is energized after it has been taken out of service and this current is extremely high for short period. So this is energizing the transformer from the rest. So the remedial feature is, in order to overcome this difficulty, differential relays are set to operate at a relatively high degree of unbalance. So here it is, high degree of unbalance means normally magnetizing currents having second harmonic content, predominant second harmonic content. So we will design a protective system using CTs with a bias or bypass this second harmonic contents. That is the magnetizing current having second harmonic content. So we will design, it will bypass that type of currents, that is magnetizing inrush current, so that the relay cannot operate at the time of energizing the transformer from the rest. So in this way, the complicating features are compensated. That is four types of complicating features. These four types of complicating features are compensated in this way. Then we will apply the circulating current principle or Mach price protection to the transformer. Such type of protection is shown in the figure, as shown in the figure you see. So this is the circulating current principle or Mach price protection applied to the transformers. Here it is the secondary winding. The secondary winding is connected in delta fashion. Similarly, these are the CTs. The CTs are connected in star fashion. See this. The CTs are common terminal and it is under terminal. So the winding of the secondary is in delta. The CTs connection is in star. Similarly, this is the primary winding. Third one is the primary winding. Primary winding also connected in delta. And these are the fourth one are the again CTs. Again CTs are also connected in star fashion. And the other terminal of the CTs are joined like this. These are called pilot cables. These are called pilot cables. Each pilot cable is connected to operating coil of the trip circuit. The three phase having three operating coils. So this principle is applied for phase to phase faults, phase to ground faults, and also interturn faults. How will work these faults? We will see. Under normal working conditions, the secondaries of the CTs carry equal currents. Therefore, the current entering the pilot cables and leaving the pilot cables is similar, that is same. Therefore, there is no differential current. Therefore, there is no differential current, the relays cannot operate. Suppose a fault occurs, that it may be earth fault or phase to phase fault, so that the CTs carrying the secondary currents in the CTs no more identical. That means there is a difference. That means the current entering the pilot cables is not equal to the current leaving the pilot cables. So there is a difference current. That differential current flows through these relays and the relays operate. Therefore, the circuit breaker disconnects the transformer from both primary side as well as secondary side. So in this way, both phase to phase faults, phase to ground faults, and it is also applied to interturn faults. Here, any one of the phase, some of the turns are short circuited. What happens? The turns ratio is altered. So this turns ratio is sufficiently enough to flow the differential current to the operating coil. Therefore, the circuit breaker again disconnect the transformer both from primary side as well as secondary side. So Majerus circulating principle is applied to the three faults, that is phase to phase faults, phase to ground faults, and interturn faults. So these are the normally protective schemes or systems applied to the transformers. Now coming to the bus bar protections. So normally bus bars in the generating stations or substations form an important link between incoming and outgoing circuits. So there is any fault on the bus bars, there will be a considerable damage as well as disruption of supply takes place. So in order to ensure the supply continuously, we will provide the protection systems bus bars also. So there are two types of protections are there. Those are types of bus bar protection. First one is differential protection. Second one is fault bus protection. Now we will see the differential protection applied to the bus bars. So I have shown the figure. It is generator generating. It is feeding the bus bar. Hello. This is the bus bar.
Hello.
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 Yes. What type of relay will be used for internal short circuit and earth fault? The transformer.
Internal short circuit.
Short circuit fault.
So internal normally that previously I will told that internal faults. That is the question is like this. Internal fault is like this. Internal faults and phase faults. What type of relay is used? Normally, interturn faults and phase to phase faults, phase to ground faults, differential relay can protect. But interturn faults are better taken care of by the Buchholz relay also. Interturn faults, that is internally coming faults, those are interturn faults. So this is better taken by the Buchholz relay also. So interturn faults can be set by the Buchholz relay also. So coming to the bus bar protection, differential protection, the generating station feeding through the current transformer and through the circuit breaker to the bus bar. Again, the bus bar is supplying two lines, that is one, here it is one, here it is through circuit breaker and CT, here it is circuit breaker and CT, and these two CTs and this CT are connected in parallel. Across this parallel combination, a relay is connected, that is the operating coil of the trip coil. So, under normal working conditions, the currents in the secondaries are identical one, that is here you see the current entering to the bus bar is equal to the current leaving the bus bar. So, therefore, there is no differential current to flow to the relay. So, it is inoperative under normal working conditions. Suppose any fault occurs on the bus bar, then what happens? Incoming current is not equal to outgoing current. So, there is a difference current. That differential current flows through this relay and the relay operates the circuit breaker. The circuit breakers, the three circuit breakers are disconnected. So, that the bus bar is isolated from the system. Like this, differential relay works. Other protection is earth fault or bus fault protection. So, this is like this, the bus fault protection is. Here it is again bus bar, it is conductor, feeding conductor 1 dash, 1 double dash, 1 triple dash are the feeding, this is the feeding conductor, this is the outgoing conductors, 2 dash, 2 double dash, 2 triple dash are the insulators. So, upon insulators, there is a bus, we call it as a metallic structure. This metallic structure is earthed through the current transformer. So, the CT is connected, secondary winding of the CT is connected to the trip circuit. So, any fault occurs, that is earth fault occurs on the bus. So, it involves a route between conductor and earth structure. So, that earth current is flows through the relay, then the relay operates and it is closes the circuit, trip coil circuit, then the trip coil disconnects the all conductors from the feeding the bus bar. So, these are the types of protections applied to the bus bars. So, now you may ask any your questions or doubts. Coming to objective type questions, earth relays have current settings, that is higher current setting or lower current setting, both higher and lower or none of the above. The correct answer is earth relays have lower current settings. Second one is Buchholz relay is installed between dash and conservator. Main tank, A is main tank, B is breather, C is explosion vent, D is none of the above. So, Buchholz relay is connected between main tank and conservator. So, the correct answer is A. Next one is Buchholz relay is a dash relay, A liquid operated, B gas operated, C both A and B, D none of the above. So, Buchholz relay is a gas operated relay. Fourth one is Buchholz relay can detect faults dash I level in the transformer, below, above, both A and B, D none of the above. So, below this I level. Okay. Earth fault current is generally dash that of short circuit current, more that of short circuit, less that of short circuit, same or none of the above. It is normally less than that of short circuit current. Mezzi-Price circulating current principle is more suitable for dash than dash. It is more suitable for generator than transformer, or transformer than generator, or bus bars than transformers, or none of the above. It is more suitable for generator than bus bar. Again, differential protection for delta star transformer, the CT should be connected in what fashion? It is delta star. The correct answer is star delta, that is D. For protection of incipient faults in the transformer, the relay used is Buchholz relay. And again, scheme of protection adapted for bus bars is split phase overcurrent, differential, reverse power, differential current. So these are the some of the object type questions. In the next session, we will discuss about the protection for feeders transmission lines.